Hi, I'm Jack Naylor, and I'm an international business student at Leeds Beckett University, and this is a vlog on my buying behaviour. Consumer buying behaviour is the sum total of a consumer's attitudes, intentions and decisions regarding the consumer's behaviour in the marketplace. When purchasing a product or service, this theory helps businesses understand why customers make the purchases they do and act the way they act. I'd like to move on to three customer buying situations. 1. Routine problem solving. 2. Limited problem solving. And 3. Extended problem solving. To explain these to you, I'll give examples and scenarios that I face and that I've faced recently. Routine problem solving are small, frequent problems, like what I'll buy on a daily basis on my weekly food shop or what I'll have for lunch. For example, I'll look at what shops are closest to me and I'll see what cash I have available to see what I can purchase. This will decide the quality and where I purchase my lunch from. This could be Morrison's, Subway or Wetherspoons, which are all close to university. I'll then purchase and consume the product. After eating, I make a decision whether it was good or bad, and I'll give feedback to myself on whether and when I'll return. I could then go to the next step and give feedback to the restaurant or shop by going online or in person. Here, I've walked you through consumer decision making. Limited problem solving is less frequent, but still quite cheap, not too expensive. I could use this in the scenario of buying a new pair of trainers. The theory I'll use, the theory of planned behaviour. By Asgen, 1991. Attitude. Attitude is to what degree the consumer is favourable or unfavourable to the valuation of the behaviour in question. So I have a positive attitude on buying a new pair of trainers, as it's what I'd like to do. Subjective norms. Subjective norms will affect what shoes I get and what others would see or expect. This may tempt me to buy a certain pair of shoes which set to be dead stock compared to buying the common brand off the shelf, for example Nike. Perceived behaviour control questions whether the good in question is a need or a want. Intention looks at how determined or willing I am to perform a want. If the shoes are known to be dead stock, it'll make me want them more than if it was a product just on the shelves which isn't limited, as the scene is more attractive and more appreciated than the shoe on shelf. Behaviour is carrying out the task of buying the product in question. The attitude and behaviours used across the three different given situations. The last one, extended problem solving, are very unfrequent, large, involving situations that will affect my life or someone else's massively. Recently I've been looking to find a house for my second year at university, and I've been visiting different houses in different locations to consider factors such as safety, transportation, amenities nearby, and room, to be honest, just within the house. This process requires a whole lot more attention to detail and takes longer in the decision making.